Well, the thing about Khaleesi is on the western side of the project, we have outcropping mineralization, skarn, epithermal, and porphyry style mineralization. And then the project, as you move further east, dips underneath an area of glacial till, which we estimate is 2 to 15 meters thick, but therefore is blind in that area before you get more outcropping mineralization on the western side.
All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Dan Symons. He is the CEO of C3 Metals. And Dan, it's good to have you back again. How are you?
I'm doing well, Steve. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, good to have you along. And I want to talk about some recent news you had out of the Khaleesi project in Peru. And again, more results from your surface mapping, rock sampling, and really that boots on the ground type work.
Yeah, that's right. You may remember we achieved a community surface access agreement in August of 2024 that really unlocked the Khaleesi area. It's always been one of our top geologic targets. And now with boots on the ground, we've done a comprehensive mapping and rock sampling program over 2 kilometers squared. And now we're shifting to a soil geochem program, and which will be followed by a geophysical program. But the early results, we're seeing copper grades up to 2.8%. Gold grades up to 6 grams per ton, molybdenum over 400 ppm. So all the signatures with the limited data that we've been able to collect so far suggests a large system.
This is obviously a large area, and you're concentrating on a specific area. Can you sort of talk about the geography of where you're starting and why you started there?
Yeah, you know, we were very quiet about trying to come in and consolidate what we thought was key ground along a very prolific world-class copper belt in southern Peru. We're less than 45 kilometers from both the Las Bambas mine, which is operated by MMG, the Constancia mine, which is operated by Hudbay Minerals. We sit really in the middle of them now with a 300 square kilometer package that we've put together quietly. The Khaleesi project in itself has never been drilled by us or anyone else. I think it's because it was a bit of a checkerboard and it needed some consolidation to take place. And we've achieved that. And then we've worked with the local indigenous community to build trust, to build that long-standing relationship to get the surface access agreement in place. So all that took the better part of 2 years. And now we're doing all the on-the-ground work that we need to do to collect the data to design the initial drill program.
Yeah, so that includes, you know, you mentioned the soil sampling, but also you're doing magnetic surveys and all that kind of stuff. You sort of talk about, and that will lead you in order to figure out some drills targets?
Yeah, absolutely. So the thing about Khaleesi is on the western side of the project, we have outcropping mineralization, skarn, epithermal, and porphyry style mineralization. And then the project, as you move further east, dips underneath an area of glacial till, which we estimate is 2 to 15 meters thick, but therefore is blind in that area before you get more outcropping mineralization on the western side. So it's the area in the middle that the soil geochemistry and the geophysical data be really important for us to understand what's happening subsurface, because the really easy way to think about this, our alteration zone that we see is a 1500 meters by 1000 meters, so 1.5 kilometers by a kilometer. The rule of thumb is, you know, a kilometer by a kilometer, if we assume 400 meters of vertical depth, that's a billion tons of rock. So what is the grade within that billion tons, and what is the continuity of that grade? We won't be able to answer that question without drilling, but we're getting all the data set ready in advance of a maiden drill program here. And this is elephant country. I mean, there's large mines all around us.
Yeah. And Dan, that's what I was going to ask you. Are you learning details from what others are doing as well, which will help you in deciding, you know, drill targets and other things on their project?
Absolutely. We look at a lot of what Las Bambas has done, because this looks like a very similar target to a Las Bambas target that MMG operates less than 45 kilometers up the way. So it looks very similar, where you have the porphyry mineralization, skarn, and epithermal all intact. So it looks like we have a chance for a full system here.
Well, exciting days ahead for sure, Dan. Thanks so much. Good to get an update from you, and we'll talk soon, okay?
Thanks, Steve. Appreciate it.
All right, there's Dan Symons, the CEO of C3 Metals.